Namaskar. Welcome to the new episode of Vande Mataram, the story of India's brave hearts. Sachindranath Sanyal was born in 1893 at village Shantipur in the Varanasi district of Uttar Pradesh. A leading figure of the Anusilan Samiti and a confirmed advocate of violence, he was animated by a strong hatred for the British government, its policies and agents. During the early part of his revolutionary career, he was engaged in organizing a revolutionary movement in Punjab and the United Provinces and became a lieutenant of Raj Bihari Bose and a connecting link with the militants of Bengal. Convicted in the Banaras Conspiracy case in 1915 and sentenced to transportation for life, he was released early in 1920 in the consequence of the royal amnesty. Ever since his release, he continued to work to promote revolutionary organization on a wider basis and devoted himself assiduously to spread the message of the revolutionary movement through literature and leaflets. He was in close touch with Pratul Ganguly, Yogesh Chandra Chatterjee, Trailukya Chakravarti, Narendranath Sen, and Prabodhchandra Das Gupta, among the prominent Bengal revolutionists, as well as with others from all parts of India. He was a member of the Executive Committee of the Nadia District Congress Committee and combined his activities in this field with his revolutionary work. He was deeply involved in a conspiracy to smuggle arms and ammunition into India from the Far East with Raj Bihari Bose and Manabendranath Roy. And Manabendranath Roy, alias Narendranath Bhattacharya. Sanyal and Mahatma Gandhi engaged in a famous debate published in Young India between 1920 and 1924. Sanyal argued against Gandhi's gradualist approach. Sanyal was known for his firm Hindu beliefs, although most of his followers were Marxist and thus opposed to religion. Bhagat Singh discusses Sanyal's belief in his tract, Why I Am an Atheist. Jagesh Chandra Chatterjee was a close associate of Sanyal. He was also supplied with guns by Maulana Shaukat Ali, who was at that time a supporter of Congress and its non-violent methods, but not with the same fervor for non-violence. That was expressed by his organization's leader, Mahatma Gandhi. Another prominent congressman, Krishna Kant Malviya, also supplied him with weapons. Busy in trafficking in arms, he was also actively plotting the commission of dacoities and murders of police officers. He was arrested on 25th February 1925 and dealt with under Ordinance 1 of 1924. On 25th September 1925, he was convicted and sentenced by the district magistrate, Bankura, to 2 years rigorous imprisonment under Section 124A in Penal Code for circulating a seditious leaflet entitled The Revolutionary in the district of Bankura on January 1925. Implicated in the Kakori case, Lucknow, he was sentenced to transportation for life on 6 April 1927 by Special Session Judge, Lucknow. Released in 1937, but arrested again in 1941. He was detained for conspiring with the foreign power, that is Japan, against the British government. Thus, Sanyal has the unique distinction of having been sent to the cellular jail in Port Blair twice. He was forced to live in an environment infested with tuberculosis and soon he contracted with tuberculosis infection in the captivity at the Andaman prison. He was transferred to Gorakhpur prison during the final phase of the infection, where he subsequently succumbed to the disease. He died on 7 February 1942. Thank you. Namaskar.